right? Am I audible? Halke khuna paisa? Okay. Okay. So what we were discussing in the last class was we were talking about certain groups of Monera, right? Eubacteria, cyanobacteria, these are the things that we have completed. Today we'll start the class with the next group of Monera, Archaebacteria, right? So please write the heading. Okay. Talking about Archaebacteria, we'll just talk about certain points and after that we'll start writing. Talking about Archaebacteria, whenever we hear about Archaebacteria, the first sentence that comes to our mind is, it is a group of primitive organisms, no? Bahut basi primitive. Second, they are bacteria, Eubacteria is also a bacteria, but they have certain types of differences. And the most important difference is obviously in terms of their cell wall structure, right? So, normal bacteria ata or Archaebacteria ata, duitare cell wall, they have certain changes, certain differences. And that is the reason what makes the Archaebacteria capable of tolerating unfavorable conditions. Because I think you all know that Archaebacteria is a group of organisms which can survive in extreme environmental condition. So, extreme environmental condition of can they survive kore? How they are capable? They should have something inside their cell that makes them capable, right? Exactly what we are talking about is the cell wall structure. They do not have a certain important chemical component that is present in the bacterial cell. Now, whenever we talk about that special chemical component present in the bacterial cell, what exactly am I referring to? Bacterial cell wall. What is the most important component of the bacterial cell wall? Yeah, please speak up. Yeah, it's peptidoglycan, right? So, because I think you remember if you are talking about the plant cell wall, we always remember cellulose, right? Similarly, if you talk about bacterial cell wall, we remember what? Peptidoglycan. This peptidoglycan is something that is absent in case of Archaebacteria, and instead of that, they have something different, right? That is one reason why they are capable of surviving. Next, we have to talk about the different types of Archaebacteria. Talking about different types, kiman type ase? Three types of Archaebacteria. What are the three types? Kiki, heard certain words called as what? Example, kunisan na Methanococcus, Methanobacter, right? Halophils, right? So we will be discussing three sections or three types of Archaebacteria. Now, before writing the points about Archaebacteria, we have to know what is the question that is asked from this portion, right? From entrance point of view, the question that is asked is the first question: peptidoglycan present or absent? Absent. Second, group of bacteria that can survive in extreme environmental conditions, Archaebacteria. Third, you have to remember certain words like, I think, why am I saying this? Because this is a portion that you all have already studied, right? So, this is just almost like a revision class. I think you remember certain words called as marshy area, right? You remember something, some bacteria producing methane. You remember a word that is called as rumen of cattle. Right? So, these are the words that you need to remember. Similarly, we will be talking about halophils, we will be talking about thermoacidophils. In that section, you will hear a word called as hot water springs. Right? So, these are the important points. No doubt the note is quite long, but in spite of that, it is only a few points that we need to remember. As far as the examples of Archaebacteria is concerned, it's very easy to understand, no? You can, if suppose a group of organisms are given and the question is asked, please identify the Archaebacteria. It's easy, kyo karne? Karan namto agot, suppose if it is methane producing bacteria, then we'll have a term called as Methanococcus. So, obviously, it's easy to understand, right? So, we'll be talking about the examples, we'll be talking about the special point and the three types of Archaebacteria. Not a very tough portion. Okay. So, what's the important hole? Peptidoglycan present? Nay, absent. It's absent in case of cell wall. So, we'll write it down. So, Archaebacteria buli kole, the first point that we'll write is, they are a group of primitive bacteria, no? So, what is important? This point, this one, then primitive extreme environmental conditions. So while you are preparing a short note, just put these words into your note so that it becomes easier, right? Next is, it lacks peptidoglycan, right? But it has something called as pseudomurine. Have you heard the word called as murine? We have already discussed when we were discussing the cell wall of eubacteria. Murine, what to hunisana nai? Murine is also called as, peptidoglycan is also called as what? Murine, it's the other name. So if the question is asked, bacterial cell wall, what is the chief component? In the option might be peptidoglycan, the option might be murine also, right? So murine, the presence of murine is a chief characteristic of a bacterial cell wall, right? In case of archaebacteria, we know peptidoglycan is absent. So we can say that murine is absent, but instead of murine, what is present is something called as a pseudomurine. Something that looks like, or something that's quite similar to murine, but not exactly similar. What is the difference? The difference is, I think you remember the words called as NAM and NEG, right? We were discussing about peptidoglycan, the chief component. Peptidoglycan is made up of two parts, the peptide part and the glycan part. Peptide part is made up of four types of amino acid. Glycan part is also made up of two types of amino acid. What are the two types? NEG and NAM. What we have talked about was NEG and NAM was present in alternating units. Ebar jodi NEG thake, after NAM thakibo. NAM after NAM, it will be NEG. So instead of NAM, so bacterial cell wall or eubacterial cell wall, NAM present. Archaebacterial cell wall, NAM absent. Instead of NAM, what they have is N-acetylosaminuronic acid. Well, question about this has not been asked. Mainly question kiya hai se, pseudomurine is a word that you need to remember, characteristic of which cell wall? It's a characteristic of the cell wall of archaebacteria. Murine is a characteristic of which cell wall? Murine is a characteristic of eubacteria, right? Next, if suppose the examiner wants to put a very tricky question, maybe at that time they'll be asking about specifically about NAM or NEG. Is NAM and NEG present in archaebacteria? NEG is present, NAM is absent, right? Okay. Next is a little bit of comparison between archae and bacteria. Kurim, is this part over, online students? Okay. Next, what you do is you just draw three columns in the form of a chart. Thank you. Antibiotic sensitivity we have already talked about when we were discussing about mycoplasma. Remember, we have talked about penicillin and tetracycline. Is it over? If this is over, the next topic would be types of archibacteria. So in this section, we don't have much to understand because it's not very tough, but you have to read the note carefully, you have to read the points carefully, right? So talking about, is this over, the chart? Once you are done with the class, since you have already got the PDF, please read the PDF properly, okay? Because in the class, we are not writing each and every sentence. We are explaining each and every word, but instead of writing each and every sentence in proper line, proper format, sometimes what we do is we write it in short. So once you go home, since you have the PDF with you, please compare it. So that will be our extra revision also. You'll remember things easily also, right? Okay. Now talking about the types of archibacteria, methanogens, halophils and thermoacidophils. I think the name itself speaks about it, right? Methanogens, if you are talking about, we understand a group of organisms or bacteria that produces methane. And where can we, where or in which areas can you see the presence of such type of organisms? Those three words, not rumen of cattle, marshy area, etc., etc. So we'll be writing about certain points. Talking about halophils, fils we understand. Filicarophobic, right? This is what is called as fils. Halo comes from the word what? We are talking about the salinity or the salt concentration. There are certain organisms which are capable of surviving only in a very high salt concentrated area, right? So these organisms are such that if the concentration of salt comes low, then they will not be able to survive, right? I think you remember a word called as obligate and facultative. Right, so you could be comparing these organisms as obligate organisms. Obligate towards what? Strict towards what? Strict towards the salt concentration. Because if the salt concentration is less, then the cell wall will burst. Right? Next, we have thermoacidophil. Thermoacido, we have two words. One is temperature, the other is acidic condition. So these are the organisms that will be capable of surviving in high temperature and high acidic conditions. So respective examples of these, right? So first of all, methanogens. Heading kora. Likhiba methane producing bacteria. Okay, talking about the first two lines that we have written, obviously a question is never going to ask about this. Methane producing bacteria are called as what? Tenekitu or question na hai. So this point is important. As far as the meaning is concerned, I think we understand. Obligate, no? Obligate, word to sobore confirm. I mean, everyone know the meaning, right? Obligate and facultative. Third bench. You jana ne sana? Obligate, facultative meaning to jana ne? Anaerobe meaning to Rana? What about the your friend? Next one? Jana ne? Anaerobes mane? Anaerobes mane na jana? Okay, it's very good that you don't know. It's nothing to feel sad, no? নাজানার কারণে এই ক্লাসত আহিছা, কিন্তু তোমালোকৰ কাম কি মোক খুঁজিব লাগে নালাগে, হয়নে? সব যদি জানাই ক্লাসলৈ কিয় আহিবা, ঘৰতে থাকিম, হয় নহয়? সো ইউ হ্যাভ ইয়ার বুকস, ইউ উইল স্টাডি এট হোম, রাইট? দ্যাট ইজ আ ওয়ে অফ স্টাডিং, এন্ড ইউ ক্যান স্টাডি হিয়ার অলসো, প্রোভাইডেড ইউ ডিড নট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড এনি ওয়ার্ড, ইটস ইয়ার ডিউটি টু আস্ক মি, নো? মই যদি প্রত্যেকটো ষ্টুডেণ্ট এনেকে পিন পইণ্ট কৰি কৰি কোৱেশ্যন সুধি থাকো, ক্লাসটো কিমান দেরি হৈ যাব? এনেই তোমালোকৰ টাইম পিৰিয়ড কি একদম কম, হয় নহয়? সো প্লিজ আস্ক ইয়ার ডাউটস, ইটস ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট টু ওয়াট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড ইচ এন্ড এভরি ওয়ার্ড ইনস্টেড অফ বাই হার্টিং ব্যাক এট হোম। ঘরত পড়িম বলে থাকিলে সময় বেশি যাব, ক্লাসতে পড়ি শেষ করা, বুঝি পাইছা? অসমীয়া বুঝি পোৱা নোপোৱা, থ্রি অফ ইউ বুঝি পোৱা? সো এন এরোবিক্স মানে কি? এরোবিক এন এরোবিক শুনিছা নাই? শুনিছা কি হয়? কোৱা না কি হব, ভুল হব, ভুল হলে হব, তোমাকতো ইয়াতে প্রাইজ দি দিয়ে ন, শুদ্ধ আনসারটা কলে বোলে তোমাকে একদম নোবেল প্রাইজ দি দিব, তো নহয়। ভুল হোক, ভুল হলে ভাল। অলওয়েজ আই টেল মাই স্টুডেন্টস, ইটস ভেরি গুড দ্যাট ইউ মেক মিস্টেক্স, অ্যান্ড নট অনলি টু মাই স্টুডেন্টস, আই টক টু মাই ডটার অলসো লাইক দিস, ইট ইজ ভেরি ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট টু মেক মিস্টেক্স। ওয়ান্স ইউ মেক মিস্টেক ইউ উইল লার্ন, ইফ ইউ ডোন্ট মেক মিস্টেক ইউ উইল নেভার লার্ন। ইটস নট ইম্পর্টেন্ট হাউ মাচ ইউ স্কোর ইন দিস ক্যাটালিস্ট এক্সামিনেশন অর সামথিং, ইটস বেটার ইউ আই মিন স্কোর লেস, কিন্তু ডাউটটা ক্লিয়ার করা। এবার যদি ভুল হয়েছে সেইটার সেকেন্ড টাইম নহয়তো, হয়নে? সো ডাউটসবিল ক্লিয়ার করবা। সো এরোবিক এন এরোবিক কি হয়? অক্সিজেন লয় বা অক্সিজেন নলয়, হয়নে? অক্সিজেন লৈ পেলাই যদি জিয়াই থাকে তাক আমি কি বলে কম? এরোবিক কম। যদি অক্সিজেন নলৈ পেলাই জিয়াই থাকে তেতিয়াহলে অক্সিজেন লেস এনভায়রনমেন্ট, এন এরোবিক। সো এন এরোবস আমি বুঝি পালো, অর্গানিজমস উইচ উইল সার্ভাইভ উইদাউট দ্য প্রেজেন্স অফ অক্সিজেন, দ্যাট ইজ কল্ড এজ এন এরোবিক। কামিং টু আ ওয়ার্ড কল্ড এজ অব্লিগেট, আসিলা নাই ক্লাসরুট? আমি রেসপিরেশন যেটা পড়াইছিল আসিলা নে? তুমি আসিলা, আসিলা নাই ক্লাসত? আসিলা নাই? নাই? কেতিয়াপর জয়েন করেছা? অক্টোবর, এইটা তো অক্টোবরই চলি আছে, পিডিএফটো আছে, পড়া নাই ঘরত, এনেকে নহব, অকান পড়িবা, ঠিক আছে? অব্লিগেট মানে কি? স্ট্রিক্ট। অসমিয়াত যদি কয় সুবিধাবাদী, ন সুবিধাবাদী নহয়, মই যত আছো মই তাতেই থাকিম, রাইট? মই খাই আছো এটা বস্তু, পার্টিকুলার মই বস্তু এটা মই খাই আছো, ভাত খাই আছো, ভাত নাখালে বা ভাত নিদিলে মই মরি যাম, কিন্তু ভাত নাখাই পেলাই চাউমিন খাম, সেইটো সুবিধাবাদী, হয়নে? ইফ ইউ ক্যান সুইচ ওভার দ্যাট ইজ কল্ড ইজ ফেকাল্টেটিভ, ইফ ইউ আর স্ট্রিক্ট দেন দ্যাট ইজ কল্ড ইজ অব্লিগেট। সো অব্লিগেট এনএরোবস মানে কি? এনেকুৱাবোৰ অর্গানিজম যোনে নেকি অক্সিজেন নহলেহে জিয়াই থাকিব পাৰে, যদি সেইবিলাক অৰ্গেনিজমছক অক্সিজেন থকা জেগাত দি দিয়া তেতিয়া কি হ'ব? মৰি যাব, মৰি যাব, ফেকাল্টেটিভ হ'লেহে জিয়াই থাকিব, বুজি পাইছা? অব্লিগেট মানে ষ্ট্ৰিক্ট, যদি মই অক্সিজেন নোহোৱাকৈ জিয়াই থাকোঁ, মই সদায় অক্সিজেন নোহোৱাকৈয়ে জিয়াই থাকিম, মোক অক্সিজেন দি দিলে মই মৰি যাম, দেট ইজ হোৱাট ইজ কল্ড এজ অব্লিগেট, ক্লিয়াৰ? প্লিজ আস্ক ইয়ৰ ডাউটছ, অ'কে? নাও প্লিজ ডোন্ট থিংক দ্যাট দিজ এ এক্সাম্পলস অফ এরিয়াজ, এরিয়াজরতো এক্সাম্পল নহয়, এইটা কিহর এক্সাম্পল? মেথেনো জিন্সর এক্সাম্পল হয়, এরিয়াটোর তলত এরোহেডাল আছে, দ্যাট ডাজ নট মিন যে মই এরিয়ার এক্সাম্পল দিছো, ঠিক আছে? এইখিনিতো বুঝি পাইছো সাগে? ওকে, thank you. So certain points about methanogen, this is all that you will learn, right? So kiki important, so obligate anaerobes. Next important, swampy or marshy areas. Next important, rumen of cattle. As far as the function of the organism is concerned, tar pra question aha nai. Enake aha nai se rumen of cattle or inside it, what do the microorganism do? Such type of a question is never asked. Question could be asked, the group of organisms present in the rumen of cattle. So we understand we are talking about methanogens. As far as the examples are concerned, examples basis or question aha nai. It is not asked. The reason behind that, because it's very easily identified. Methane producing bacteria, so we have a word called as methane there, right? So examples not very important, but the points that we have marked, especially swampy and marshy area and the rumen of cattle, and obviously this word gobar gas and this word, right? So as I told before also, you have to make a short note. In the short note from this unit, what you are going to write, only those words, those words will give you an idea about the entire group. So gobar gas produce koribole tahate help kore. So this is all about the first one. Next likha number 2, halophils. মই প্ৰথমে লিখি লওঁ, দেন উইল চে উইচ পইণ্টছ আৰ ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট। Thank you. So these are the points about halophils. What is the first point? Gram negative. Since we are talking about bacteria, we use two words, gram positive and gram negative. In case of eubacteria, what we have seen, some of them are gram positive, some are negative. In case of archaebacteria also, we see some as positive, some as negative, but maximum of them are always gram negative. You cannot be saying that all archaebacteria are gram negative, but maximum of them are gram negative in nature. And if I talk about gram negative, I think you remember we have talked about the cell wall composition also, the structure of the cell wall. Ki thake, what was so special about gram negative? Extra layer, right? Juntu niki positive or na thake. Okay, talking about this, they can survive in extreme salt concentration. We understand the term itself talks about it. We have a term called as plasmolysis. What is plasmolysis? Shrinkage of the protoplasm. Something more? Shrinkage of the protoplasm away from the cell wall, or when the cell is placed in dash solution. Plasmolysis hobo lagile cell to kibat hobo lagibo hypertonic. So these are the words that you have to remember, right? Plasmolysis, first point, the most important characteristic of a living cell, right? Every living cell will undergo plasmolysis. Second, when will it undergo plasmolysis? When it is placed in a hypertonic solution. What is a hypertonic solution? Jar salt concentration is more than the cell sap, less than the cell sap? More than the cell sap. You have a cell, the cell is placed in a solution, right? Etu ki buli kom? Cell sap, taru eta concentration thakibo, right? Concentration means what? What exactly we are talking about? Ki hor concentration? Solutes, right? Right? Similarly, if this also has a specific concentration, if the concentration is more and if this concentration is less, then everything will come out, right? I think you have talked about, or you have learned about words called as endoosmosis, osmosis, isotonic solution, hypertonic solution, etc., etc., right? So we understand what is called as plasmolysis. Next, if a halophil is placed in low salt concentration, it will get lysed. Lysed mane, the word has come from the word called as lysis. Lysis is nothing but breaking down, right? Hi bhangi jabo, the cell will break down. Next, again this point, the question has been asked about this also, right? So under light or under high light intensity, they will always develop a pigment. A pigment to ketia form korbo jeta light beshi thakibo. Under low light, they will never form this pigment, right? So as far as the pigment is concerned, whenever we talk about pigment, we generally remember photosynthetic pigments, right? If you're talking about photosynthetic pigments, what is the most important function? They will capture in light. If they capture in light, after capturing light, what is the product? In case of photosynthesis, obviously they will go for food preparation. But as we have already written over here, are they photosynthetic? No, they are not photosynthetic. But they are not photosynthetic. In spite of that, they will capture light. Since they capture light, those reactions would be responsible for the production of energy in the form of ATP. And ATP would be used by the organism for their metabolic activities. Right? So, iman details na lage, khali ki monot rakhiba? Highlight of pigment key form for a bacterial rhodopsin. Question could also be asked is, the pigment bacterial rhodopsin is seen in. In seen in, answer or option could be archaebacteria, option could be specifically halophils also. Slightly chemically different. Okoman component. Kino posto to eke. Karan ultimately he light lobo. Light lobo play reactions obo. Reactions mane ki electrons bilak move koribo. Electrons bilak move kori. Pathway move kori kori ultimately tahate. Aru iman easy no hoy. Iman aru light lole ATP produce kori. Tene karo no hoy no. Symptoms conditions lagi bo ATP produce kori. You know, almost the same. Thik ase? So we'll be remembering this point, this one, and gram negative. Agor to ki asile anaerobic. Etu ki hoy aerobic. Right? I think it's over. Likhila. Next, likha the third one, thermoacidophils. So out of this, what is important is just this word, okay? So this is all the portion that you have to learn from Archivectiva. Just a few points to remember, right? Once you write the note, it looks as if you are writing a lot of information, but if you choose the information that are ticked or pinpointed, it's just a few words that you remember. So we have completed the next group. As I have said in the first class, we have to talk about five groups or five types of monera. Here we have completed the fourth type. Next we'll be talking about the last type of monera, that is actinomycetes. So please make the heading actinomycetes. So what are the four types that we have discussed? Monera, if you remember, there are eight types of monera. What are the four types we have discussed? We have talked about Eubacteria, Cyanobacteria, Mycoplasma, and then Archibacteria. And the fifth one is okay. So actinomycetes, before writing the note, let's see what are the points you need to remember. Actinomycetes boli kole jeneke archibacteria boli kole, the first word that comes to our mind is extreme environmental conditions, right? Thik jeneke if you talk about actinomycetes, the first word that comes to our mind is they are called as filamentous bacteria. Why this word is important? Because whenever we talk about bacteria, we know it is made up of just a single cell, unicellular in structure. But if I use the word called as filamentous, then obviously we understand a thread-like structure. If it has to form a thread-like structure, then many cells needs to get assembled, right? So this is the special point about actinomycetes. It is also called as ray fungi, or it is also called as ray bacteria. Why is it called as ray, or why are we using the word ray? Because it is filamentous. The filament looks like a ray. Right, normally bacteria bilak ketiyo filamentous nohoy, no tate tenika nohoy. Etu bele kotha je coccus, sorry, we have talked about the different types of coccus, different types of bacillus, hebilak bele kotha, right? Hetu to eta eta individual, they form a group of two, a group of four. We have talked about those things, no? But if you are talking about this one, it is originally in the form of a filament, so they are called as filamentous bacteria. Second, since they look like a filament, they are supposed to form a link between two organisms, bacteria and fungi. Because fungi, whenever we use the word, we understand their, or we have an idea about their thallus or their body structure. Fungi body structure, filamentous. I think you have heard a word called as mycelium. राइट माइसेलियम की होय आ फिलामेंट थ्रेड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर सो इहटरो की थाके फिलामेंट थाके सो लिंक बिटवीन बैक्टीरिया एंड फंजाई सेकंड पॉइंट द थर्ड सिंस दे हैव सर्टेन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स विद बैक्टीरिया सो वी हैव टू टॉक अबाउट द स्टेनिंग प्रोसेस ऑल्सो राइट वी विल बी यूजिंग अ वर्ड कॉल्ड एज एक्टिनोमाइसिटीज आर एसिड फास्ट इन नेचर राइट एसिड फास्ट जैसे कि बैक्टीरिया वी हैव यूज द वर्ड ग्राम पॉजिटिव और ग्राम नेगेटिव डिपेंडिंग ऑन द स्टेनिंग प्रॉपर्टी दीज बैक्टीरिया दे विल नॉट बी स्टेन बाई ग्राम नेगेटिव आई मीन दे विल नॉट बी स्टेन विद ग्राम स्टेन इंस्टेड दे टेक अप अनदर स्टेन and those organisms that take up that specific stain carbolfusin mo likhai dim right they are called as acid fast in nature so question kene ke ahe identify the organism that is acid fast in nature the organism that is acid fast in nature answer would be in case of this it will be actinomycin there are other examples also right and the last and the most important thing is if you are talking about microorganisms we remember the word antibiotics also Maximum of the antibiotics are produced from or obtained from key microorganisms. Antibiotics could be made from or obtained from obviously bacteria, fungal antibiotic ko thake, bacterial antibiotic thake, but actinomycetes antibiotic ko thake. And out of the antibiotics that are produced or that has been obtained, more than 100 types of antibiotics are obtained from this group. So fungal antibiotic, bacterial antibiotic and actinomycetes antibiotic, which one is more? It's obviously actinomycetes in antibiotics, origin that has an actinomycetes is obviously more. So these are the points that we need to remember. Keyword, first is filamentous, second is acid fast in nature, third is the types of antibiotics, right? Okay, likha. This word is important. Question to NAK wa hai, identify the filamentous bacteria. So identify the filamentous bacteria bhuli kule. Filamentous bacteria ki hoi? Nothing but actinomycetes itself, right? Okay, if you have previously gone through the MCQs, because this is a portion that you have already studied, no? Biological classification, ebar to tumalke porisa. Do you remember anything about Frankia? Very, very important example. Hodai question to Frankia report ahe. Something related with what? Nitrogen fixation. Because symbiotic nitrogen fixation, root nodules, these words are not related with this one. Right? We'll be writing that point. So this is very important, okay? I'm not writing it in sentence, just busy puake. Okay. If I talk about a group of microorganisms that has similarities with fungi, what is the point that you understand as far as reproduction is concerned? What will be the means of reproduction for these organisms? You have an organism that has similarity with fungi. That is one hint that you already know. Now, as far as the reproduction of these organisms is concerned, obviously they will have similarity with fungi. So talking about reproduction in fungi, what is the most common means of reproduction? Spore formation. So they will also reproduce with the help of spores, right? And again, by this word, one means of reproduction, fermentation. Okay, from these portions that we have written, ray fungi. Right. Next is filamentous ray fungi. Examples, especially this one, and this one important. Eduta iman important no hoy. Next is important decomposers reproduced by. As far as conidia, sporangia, zoospore, oidia, the meaning of these are concerned, we'll be discussing in details during our fungi class. Because these are the structures that are seen also in case of fungi. Because if you remember, fungi ki kore, asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction, both types of reproduction are seen in fungi. If you are talking about asexual, then obviously it's obviously by means of various types of spores. Now you have to understand when a spore is called as a sporangiospore, when a spore is called as a conidia, when a spore is called as oidia. So ebu description ami fungi class out kori, right? Okay, talking about fungi, I think this is the most important. I mean spore from the fungi section, and the questions has been asked about this also. Key question hai conidia report e question hai fungi mane if you are talking about that diagram, example of a fungi that reproduces with the help of conidia, specific example to penicillin, right? He to report enu kara diagram as na fungi korim, right? Ba kuntu spore ok conidia ko ba no जितिया स्पोर्स बिलक चेन आउट अरेंज हुए थके जितिया है हमी कोनीडिया को ओके दिस इज अ फंजाई पोर्शन सो विल बी डिस्कसिंग लेटर एंड नेक्स्ट सिंस दे हैव अ रिलेशन विद फंजाई देन ऑब्वियसली दे वुड बी सेप्रोफाइटिक एंड दे वुड बी डिकम्पोजर्स फंजाई की होय डिकम्पोजर्स व्हाट द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट कंटिन्यू करा they cannot no filament is true segmentation mycelium that word jehetu filament type bacteria bilak filament no it is similar second similarity saprophytic third similarity decomposers right fourth similarity production of spores for reproduction So when we talk about this group, we remember gram positive. When we talk about archibacteria, we remember gram negative, right? right? So acid fast in nature, what to monitor rakhim? Kyo acid fast buli koise? Because they get stained with a particular stain that is called as carbolfusin, that is red in color, they appear red. Now sometimes the question might be asked je ki ho karne gram stain na hoy, right? Because we have written the answer, because they have a specific component, mycolic acid, and mycolic acid prevents that organism to take up the gram stain. Is this over? Ekini hole ekbar hobo pisot likhi thak. Acid fast माने acid fast कुन बिलाक organisms, acid fast is a term that is used on the basis of staining, right? If a group of organisms take up a particular stain that is called as carbolfusin, you use a word that these organisms are acid fast in nature, right? और तहाँ ते gram positive होए, structure तो gram positive, किन्तु तथा भी तहाँ ते gram stain नॉल होए, so क्या बात है बेलेक stain रे कोई बोले ये बो, right? So यदि है carbolfusin लोए, तहाँ तो कमी की बोली कम acid fast. Second, carbolfusin ketia lobo, jeta mycolic acid basically thakibo. So in other way around, you can also explain like this, our organisms which has a huge amount of mycolic acid are called as acid fast in nature, right? Okay. Thank you. since we are talking about antibiotics, so question might be asked, identify the eubacterial antibiotic or identify the antibiotic having actinomycetin origin. So kuntu korpra abstract korese hetu question kudiba. Is this part over? Is this over? What? Okay, next is, as I said, one example of actinomycetes as a Strankia, here to report a maximum question. What is the question that is asked? Something related with nitrogen fixation, right? Now, whenever you hear this word nitrogen fixation, what is the example that you remember? Leguminous plants is the word that you remember, and the example of the microorganism? Rhizobium. Another word, there are three words that you always remember. Root nodules, leguminous plants and rhizobium, right? We have an idea as if nitrogen fixation bully kole hoda etu example hobo, right? Not necessary, because we know nitrogen can be fixed both symbiotically and asymbiotically also, not necessarily always symbiotically. Not necessarily always in case of nitrogen fixation root nodules would be formed. Not necessarily always nitrogen fixation will occur inside leguminous plants only, right? As far as this is concerned, why is this important? Because so this is something that is related to atmospheric nitrogen. We know atmospheric nitrogen fixation bully kole. This is also a word that we know. This is also a word that we know. These are common. Kintu what is the unique point? Non-legume. So question ahe, symbiotically atmospheric nitrogen fixation in non-legumes is conducted by. So this word, because if you are talking about legumes, we remember rhizobium. If you are talking about non-legumes, you have to remember Frankia. Example of non-legumes plants. Elnas. So, khodai elnas or Frankia, a duta reporter question to ahe. Right? The question is also always asked between this and this. So, the question that is put is like this, something like this. The organism responsible for fixation of nitrogen in elnas. Or in a non-legume called elnas, or who fixes nitrogen in elnas. So the question always revolves around these two words, right? No doubt we have written three examples, but out of that elnas to basically put it back. Another point. Is the statement understood? এটা বুঝি পাইছনে নাই? কিহৰ কথা কৈ আছো? Not only we don't have to think about plowed area also, we don't have to think about forest, right? In any place, ঘৰটো প্ৰথম বৰষুণ দিলে, right? After a very dry season, the first rain always brings along a smell of the soil. Right? এটা মাটিৰ গোন্ধ ওলায়. And in that case, if you want to smell it, you can put water in a brick also. ইটা এটুকুৰ ল'বা, পানী অকণমান ঢালি দিবা, কি হ'ব, গোন্ধ এটা ওলাব. Right? So, this is also because explanation will never be asked. কি সুধিব? Earthy smell responsible actinomycetes. Why? Because of the secretion of a chemical called geosmin. Second question, geosmin is secreted by actinomycetes. That's all. So, this is all about the last type of monera that we have to discuss, that is actinomycetes. So, কারণ সেই নহয় তাহাঁতৰ কেমিকেল ৰিয়েকশ্যনছ হয় ন, ইমান দেৰি ড্ৰাই হৈ থাকে তাহাঁতৰ কেমিকেলছবিলাকৰ বডি যোনটো ষ্ট্ৰাকচাৰ তাত পানী পৰি পেলাই. Okay, so types of monera we have completed, and this brings an end to the first kingdom. We are discussing about what? We are talking about biological classification. What is included in the chapter? The different types of classification systems, the different types of kingdoms included in the classification. Which classification system is most accepted? Whittaker's classification system. Whittaker's classifies the organisms into how many kingdoms? 5 kingdoms. On the basis of what? R.H. Whittaker has given or proposed the 5 kingdom classification, right? On the basis of what? ইমান নালাগে, কোৱেশ্যনটো ডাইৰেক্টলি এটাই আহিব. দ্য আৰ এইচ হুইটেকাৰ ছিষ্টেম অফ ক্লাছিফিকেশ্যন ইজ প্ৰপ'জ অন দ্য বেচিছ অফ ড্যাশ. ইফ ইউ ৰিমেম্বাৰ, উই হেভ ৰিটেন 5 পইণ্টছ, চেল ৱাল ষ্ট্ৰাকচাৰ, অৰ্গেনাইজেশ্যন, চেল ষ্ট্ৰাকচাৰ, নিউট্ৰিশ্যন, ৰিপ্ৰডাকশ্যন, এভৰিথিং. বাট ৱাট ইজ দ্য পইণ্ট? নিউট্ৰিশ্যন, ৰাইট? চ' আৰ এইচ হুইটেকাৰ হেজ গিভেন দ্য 5 কিংডম ক্লাছিফিকেশ্যন অন দ্য বেচিছ অফ মোড অফ নিউট্ৰিশ্যন, বিকজ উই ন' দ্য প্লেচমেণ্ট অফ ফাঞ্জাই ৱাজ নট ক্লিয়াৰ. আগতে কি আছিলে? অৰিজিনেল ক্লাছিফিকেশ্যন, অল দ্য অৰ্গেনিজমছ আৰ ডিভাইডেড ইন টু প্লাণ্টছ এণ্ড এনিমেলছ, নেক্সট ৱৰ্ড প্ৰটেষ্টা, নেক্সট ৱৰ্ড মনেৰা. বাট চিন্স দে হেড আ প্ৰব্লেম অফ প্লেচিং ফাঞ্জাই ইন টু আ পাৰ্টিকুলাৰ কিংডম, আ ছেপাৰেট কিংডম ৱাজ ফৰ্মড, এণ্ড আল্টিমেটলি উই নাও হেভ 5 কিংডম ছিষ্টেম. চ' অবভিয়াছলি ইফ ইটছ ৰিলেটেড উইথ ফাঞ্জাই, দেন উই আৰ টকিং এবাউট দ্য নিউট্ৰিশ্যন ইন ফাঞ্জাই. ৱাই? বিকজ ফাঞ্জাই হেজ চ' মেনি চিমিলাৰিটিজ উইথ দ্য প্লেণ্ট কিংডম. As far as the body structure is concerned, they have many similarities, but what's the point of difference? The difference is obviously the most important mode of nutrition. One is photosynthetic, the other is saprophytic, right? Okay. So monera jehetu hol, we'll be talking about the next kingdom. Ki asile? Protista. Before starting this kingdom, what we remember, we have the most ancient or the primitive kingdom, that is Monera. From the Monera, Protista, and from Protista, right, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. So this point is the starting point if you have to study about Protista. The first line about Protista, it is one kingdom that has a lot of diverse organisms. One kingdom that has a lot of diverse organisms. By means of, or the meaning of that diverse, what we are referring to is it has different types of organisms. What if I talk about Monera, the first line that you remember about Monera is it is a kingdom of dash ki. Monera, so a plant kingdom boli kole, it's a kingdom of plants. If you talk about animal kingdom, it's a kingdom of animals. If you talk about Monera, it's a kingdom of what? Prokaryotes. Prokaryotes, not bacteria, because we have cyanobacteria, archaebacteria, etc. So it's a kingdom of prokaryotes. If you talk about Protista, the one word, it's a kingdom of unicellular eukaryotes, right? Obviously, unicellular eukaryotes is the first one. Second is, this is a kingdom that will have organisms that resemble fungi. It will have organisms that resemble plants and organisms that resemble animals. So, this is the only one kingdom that has diverse organisms, right? Because of that reason, it is also considered as a junk box. Have you heard this word? Junk box, Anu, no? Every house has a junk box. Anything that you don't want, you put it there. You have a broken pen, you don't feel like throwing it away. What do? I told you so. Right? You have a paper, you don't want to fill it. I mean, you don't want to tear it off or throw it away. You just put it in one corner. Right? So, that is what is called, considered as a junk box. You have different organisms, different things in one area. So, protista is considered as a junk box because it is this kingdom that will have plant-like protist, animal-like protist and fungi-like protist. Right? Next. Talking about protists, out of this, so first one, unicellular eukaryotes. Second is, consists of three types of organisms. Out of these three types of organisms, plant-like protists is something that we have to talk in details. Plant-like protists, we have to talk about three words. Kiki asile. Diatoms, dinoflagellates and euglena, right? So, out of this, obviously this is not our part, botany part na hoy. Fungi-like protists we'll have to talk about. Here we'll be talking about slime molds. Porisa ne na agore? Porisa. One word about slime mold that you remember. Just one word. Slime mold ki hoy? Answer to tumoi diye lilo. Fungi-like protists. So, it is obviously unicellular eukaryote. Just forget about all those things. One word about slime molds. Saprophytic. Yeah, saprophytic because it's fungi-like. Right? No. A very important word that starts with P associated with that group. Plasmodial formation, plasmodium. Khunisane word to? Plasmodium formation, pseudoplasmodium formation. What is plasmodium? A group. Right? So, plasmodial formation could dekhapam. Slime molds or dekhapam. Right? Okay. Next is talking about animal-like protist. Animal-like protists are called as protozoans. Examples of protozoans, zoology class. But some examples like Giardia. Giardia kunisa na? Diarrhea, it causes diarrhea. Trypanosoma causes what? Sleeping sickness. So, these are examples of animal-like protists. Next is animal-like protists, what you need to remember? That these protists are divided by on the means of locomotion. What is their locomotory organ? Some organisms will move with the help of cilia. Some organism will move with the help of flagella. So, accordingly, we'll have a word called as ciliates. We'll have a word called as flagellates. So, these falls under animal-like protists. So, nothing in details. So, what we are going to discuss is this one and this one in details. Next, before starting this, the question that is asked from protista, the most common question. First is certain terms, no? If you remember, do you remember a word called as glass house? Okay. Do you remember a word called as jewels of the plant kingdom? No. Do you remember a word called as soap box? Duta part, thika, right? Next, whirling movement, spinning movement, dinoflagellates, right? And if you are talking about the jewels and glass house and all this, these are related with diatoms. Next, a word, diatomaceous earth. The cell wall does not get destructed and so it keeps on accumulating. Ultimately, it forms diatomaceous earth. Why is it important? It has economic importance. Which question is asked from that portion? Filtration of oils and syrup with the help of diatomaceous earth. Second, soundproofing. If you want to make a room soundproof, then you use what? Diatomaceous earth. That is, those are the things that are important from the diatoms. Another point that is important from the diatom, it produces half of earth's oxygen, right? The three points. Talking about dinoflagellates, the next group of plant-like protists, first word, armored dinoflagellate, because the cell wall is very thick and rigid, it looks like an armor. I think we understand what an armor is. Army people, they used to wear an armor around their body, right? So, their cell wall is very thick, it's very rigid, so we use a word called as armored. Second point, dinoflagellates or dinoflagellate, the name is given on the basis of what? Presence of two flagella, right? Third point, they have a special type of movement that is called as a spinning movement. Why? What is spinning? Moving around in circles in the same area is called as spinning. That is also called as whirling. I think you heard the word called as whirlpool. Washing machine, whirlpool. The word has come from that whirling movement itself. So what is whirling? You move around in circles in the same area. Dinoflagellates or dinoflagellates have two flagella, right? With the help of flagella, they will move from one place to another. But the unique point is they have one flagella in a transverse area or transverse flagella and the other flagella, horizontal flagella. Since adult flagella enake gose, adult flagella enake gose, which way they will move? So they keep moving in the same area. That is a special type of movement seen in dinoflagellates. Third important point about dinoflagellates, something called as bioluminescence. Heard about this word bioluminescence? Amar jeneke junaki porua ase, right? Bioluminescence, a word called as sea ghost. Why is it called a sea ghost? Because it lights up during the night, right? Sea ghost, the example, especially gonulax. Another most important, red tide. Two words, red sea, red tide. Red sea we have already discussed. Red sea ko discuss korisilo. The organism responsible for red sea or associated with the red sea. Ita gompam kiman korisa. So this is a hint. So the answer comes from the portion that we have already discussed. Cyanobacteria. Trichodesmia mellitrum. Right? Red sea. But here we'll be talking about red tide. Who is responsible for red tide? Dinoflagellate, protista, example we'll be discussing. Who is responsible for red sea? Cyanobacteria. What is the example? Trichodesmia erythrium. These are the points from this. Next, coming to the third one, that is euglena. Euglena, so what's the important point? Since we are talking about euglena as an example of plant-like protista, obviously photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic. Photosynthetic, right? That is so, okay, they are green in color, chloroplast present, photosynthesis. Something important about their cell wall. Cell wall present? No, absent. Absent, right? So, instead of a cell wall, what they have? A covering that is called as pellicle, right? This is the one important. And obviously, euglena forms a link between plant and animal because they have plant-like characters and animal-like characters. So, this is the content that we are going to discuss. Nilikhileo hoy jodi, let's complete protista like this only. So I can say that I have completed protista. Okay, so kingdom protista first, karaman point likho. PDF paisa nai, paisa sake. Disu gute, entirely disu. Entirely disu kane suwa nai. Part part ke dile akon suwa hoy. Give me an example of a multicellular eukaryote. Give me an example of a unicellular eukaryote. Dinoflagellates, diatoms, euglena, unicellular eukaryote. Give me an example of a multicellular eukaryote. Himan sinta koi pula gaha se. Nizor nizor naam kita koi le hoi jai. We are the examples of what? Multicellular eukaryotes. Yeah. Thank you. এগিটা ওয়ার্ড শুনিছা নাই হলোফাইটিক হলোজয়িক রাইট হলোফাইটিক ফটোসিনথেটিক হলোজয়িক ইনজেস্টিভ ইনজেস্টিভ মিন্স ইটিং ইট উইথ দ্য হেল্প অফ ইয়োর মাউথ দ্যাট ইজ কল্ড ইজ ইনজেস্টিভ এন্ড অ্যাজ ফার এজ অ্যাবজর্বটিভ স্যাপ্রোফাইটস অ্যাবজর্বটিভ ওয়াইল ওয়ে আর টকিং অ্যাবাউট নিউট্রিশন উই হ্যাভ টু রিড আনাদার ওয়ার্ড এইটোৰ ওপৰত কুৱেশ্যন আহে মিক্সট্ৰপিক নিউট্ৰিশ্যন ইজ ছিন ইন ইউগ্লিনা ৰাইট দ্য টাইপ অফ নিউট্ৰিশ্যন ইন ইউগ্লিনা মিক্সট্ৰপিক এজ এ নেম ছাজেষ্ট মিনছ ইট হেজ এ মিক্সচাৰ অফ টু ৰাইট চ' ছেপ্ৰোফাইটিকো প্লাছ ফটোছিনথেটিকো হ'ব অৰ্গেনিজমছবিলাক কাৰণ প্ৰতিষ্ঠাৰ অৰ্গেনিজমছবোৰ ক'ৰ পৰা ইভল্ভ হৈছে মনেৰাৰ পৰা ইভল্ভ হৈছে চ' কিছুমান ছিমিলাৰিটিজ উইথ মনেৰাৰ বা অৰ্গেনিজমছ বেক্টেৰিয়াৰ লগত কিছুমান ছিমিলাৰিটিজ কিছুমান ছিমিলাৰিটিজ ফাঞ্জাই প্লেণ্টি আৰু এনিমেলিয়া ৰাইট So this word mixotropic nutrition or the type of nutrition seen in Euglena, you cannot be writing the word photosynthetic, that is also correct, but you have to be specific with this word, theek ase mixotropic. Next, ekhini to ami bujhi paiso holophytic and all those, talking about this locomotion in protist, different types of locomotory organs, specially which one we are talking about, the animal like protist. Obviously, plant will act to no hoy, kintu tarap Euglena, diatoms they will also have because they are lower organisms, right? Next, because xenoflagellates, obviously they are plant-like photosynthetic, protists, but in spite of that, they have flagella, right? Coming to this word, remember? Have you heard this word before? Related with what? 9 plus 2 and duta asile no, eta 9 plus 2, aru eta 9 plus 0. What are we talking about? 9 plus 2 what? Remember cytoskeleton, the skeleton of a cell, right? How does it look like? What it is made up of? It is made up of certain tube-like structures that is called as microtubule, microfilaments and intermediate fibers, right? Talking about 9 plus 2, you have to talk about two types of cytoskeleton, one of the basal body and the other of cilia and flagella. Right, basal body aru cilia flagella. Cilia flagella ki thakibo 9 plus 2. Right, so we'll be talking about it in during a cell class. So 9 plus 2 means what? 9 microtubules and 2 microtubules. Right, remember a word called as cartwheel like structure. Cartwheels ni pao no, goru gari jonto heavy hoy. cartwheel like structure, right? Something related with the microtubule, something like this, no? এনেকে কেইটা থাকিব নটা তাৰপিছত এনেকে সৰি নট দিছ এনেকে 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 আছিল ন দেট কাৰ্ট উইল সো দিছ ইজ দ্য চাইটোস্কেলিটন অফ দ্য ফ্লাজিলা অন চিলিয়া জাষ্ট ৰিমেম্বাৰ দিছ ওৱান এজ অফ নাও ডিটেইলছ ইন দ্য চেল ক্লাছ রিপ্রোডাকশন বোথ আসেক্সুয়াল এন্ড সেক্সুয়াল ইফ ইউ আর টকিং অবাউট আসেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন উই নো দ্যাট দিস ইজ আ ক্যারেক্টারিস্টিক অফ লোয়ার অর্গানিজমস রাইট টকিং অবাউট সেক্সুয়াল ক্যারেক্টারিস্টিক অফ হায়ার অর্গানিজম দ্য ফার্স্ট কিংডম দ্যাট উই হ্যাভ স্টাডিড ইজ মোনেরা ইজ সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন সিন ইন মোনেরা নো কমপ্লিটলি অ্যাবসেন্ট উই হ্যাভ সামথিং কল্ড এ সেক্সুয়াল রিকম্বিনেশন বাট নট সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন দ্য নেক্সট কিংডম প্রোটিস্টা সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন দেখা পাও না পাও Yes, so the first kingdom where sexual reproduction had started developing, Protista. And since we are talking about the first or the primitive type of sexual reproduction, three words are associated. Talking about sexual reproduction, one type that is seen in higher organisms, if you talk about a plant, angiosperm, gymnosperms, whatever, that to sexual reproduction, we see the formation of gametes, this and that. Have you heard the words called as isogamy, anisogamy and oogamy? Isogamous, anisogamous and oogamous. Eblak ki hoy? What are these? These are nothing but primitive forms of sexual reproduction. Since the process of sexual reproduction has just started in this kingdom, we have to talk about the types of sexual reproduction. So in the next class, we'll be discussing about types of sexual reproduction seen in the kingdom Protista. Aru ki ki? Isogamous, anisogamous and oogamous. I think that's all for today. Doubts kiba asil niki? Any doubts? Okay, then I think it's understood. Thank you.